To say that the Mission Viejo Nadadores swim team put Mission Viejo on the map is an understatement. The Nadadores are one of the most prominent swim teams in all of swimming. Today, we're proud to spend time with the swimmers that make up the trials team in hopes of competing at the Olympic Games. Led by Coach Bill Rose, the Nadadores will once again take center stage in the most important competition on the planet. It's a very special show. I'm Paul Higgins. This is Coach's Corner, and all the action starts right now. I'm Paul Higgins, and welcome to this edition of Coach's Corner. Bill Rose and I were just talking about it. It's hard to believe the 2016 Olympic Games are right around the corner. And the Mission Viejo Nadadores, well, today they celebrated their send-off. Today we'll talk to five of those athletes getting ready to represent Mission Viejo in one way or the other, hopefully in the Olympic Games. And again, I'm Paul Higgins, Bill Rose joining me, and also she graduated from Santa Margarita High School, and she's at Cal doing some great things in the sport of swimming, Katie McLaughlin. And Katie is participating in four different events, and we'll talk to you about that. But first of all, Coach, congratulations. What a great day it was today with all of your athletes as you had the send-off party for the Olympic trials in Omaha, Nebraska. How excited are you right now?
You know, it's so great. Every 4 years, I mean, our whole year is leading up to this, and the fact that we leave in just a few days is just amazing, and it's something that everybody dreams about.
Katie, you've had such great success. If I was to read your bio, we would be here for way too long.
Thank you.
So congratulations on that.
Thank you.
But Coach, recently she was a gold medal award winner in the 800 freestyle for the team. And where was that again? That was in Russia?
Kazan, Russia. It was the World Championships last year.
Katie, I know you're anticipating. You leave in a couple days. Has the reality of that set in? Are you nervous? I mean, you've traveled the world already as such a young athlete. This is just another stepping stone. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I mean, I'm definitely nervous, and it comes in waves. Like, I mean, some days I'll be more nervous than others, I would say. But I'm excited, and I'm glad I can travel with the Nadadores and be with my team and friends, so it'll be fun.
And you mentioned friends, because I asked you, I said, what is your favorite event? And you said the 200 fly. The other event you're doing is the 100 fly, the 200 free, and also the 100 free. The 200 fly, why is that your favorite event?
I just like all the friends that I've made through swimming it. I mean, you kind of see the same people swimming the same event, so, you know, it's good to meet friends through that and keep in touch and stuff.
Coach Rose was just speaking off camera to me, and he said, Paul, you know, it's changed a lot. Swimming has changed. You're a young lady, what, of 19?
18.
18 years old. And the norm now for the Olympic Games is for females around 25.
Right.
So you're not even there yet, and here you are trying to qualify for the Olympics. How exciting is that?
Yeah, it's definitely really exciting. I mean, I have a lot of friends my age that are going to be there too, so yeah, it'll be fun.
What does it take for you to make it? I mean, does it take you to have your best swim ever? Does it take somebody to have not such a great swim? And your perception in your mind against your competition, how are you going to take that next step?
I think it's about staying in my own race. You can't really control what other people are going to do around you, so it's just trying to have the best race I can at that day. So.
And Coach, what type of advice do you give Katie and your other swimmers as she gets ready? I know every athlete you give different advice to. For Katie, can you give us some insight?
Katie,
she's heard it before.
Katie is a great competitor. There's no question about that. And I think she does better when she just doesn't have to worry about it. Just go out and do your best. Race like you're a 10-year-old, you know, and the rest of them will take care of itself. So, indeed, it's something that she loves the sport, and as long as she loves the sport and loves the race, I don't need to tell her too much.
Oh, that's good advice, Coach.
Yeah.
Sometimes the best advice is very little advice, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Katie, your parents are great athletes, and you have a younger brother, right, playing water polo at Dana Hills High School, so you're leading the charge in your family. What will your parents say to you before you leave, and will they go with you?
Yeah, my parents are going to be there, and I think my brother will be there for a few days too, but I think they would just tell me to have fun and I don't know, take it in and just have a good experience. They wouldn't put any pressure on me at all, so just as long as I'm enjoying myself, I'll be happy.
Well, I think you will. Only 18 years old, she's achieved such great success. We wish Katie all the best of luck on her way to the Olympic trials in Omaha. We'll be back with four more Nadadores right here on Coach's Corner after this.
Mission Basilica School is a Catholic parochial school with single grade classrooms from pre-kindergarten through eighth grade.
We have absolutely the best to offer in education. We don't just educate the child academically. They are nurtured spiritually. They are guided through their spiritual journey. They are loved, every being of them.
A blue ribbon school for academic excellence, located on the beautiful grounds of Mission San Juan Capistrano, Mission Basilica School.
Hello everybody, welcome back to this edition of Coach's Corner here on location in the city of Mission Viejo. This complex was actually built in 1972, and that's really when the Nadadores started to kick in. The Nadadores were around before 1972, but of course this beautiful facility is really what put them on the map among great athletes as well. Well, the facility is changing, if you haven't heard. In the next year it's going to get a facelift, over an $8 million facelift, and Coach Bill Rose will oversee the entire project along with the city of Mission Viejo. Right, Coach?
I am going to oversee it, but at the same time, I really want to make sure I give a shout out to the city of Mission Viejo, because not only financially are they helping us out and building and rebuilding a beautiful complex that is known worldwide. And they've been very, very good to us and helping us find other pools and so on, because we're going to be out of here for at least a year. And so to displace 700 to 800 swimmers for that period of time, we've needed some real help, and the city has really reached out to help.
Well, I know you wanted to make mention of that. Again, City of Mission Viejo, very instrumental in what goes on here with the Nadador Complex. Well, joining us now is Stephanie Peacock. She is an excellent swimmer, came to the Nadadores about 9 months ago. Stephanie, welcome to the Nadadores. Welcome to the show.
Oh, hi, thank you.
You went to school in North Carolina. We talked about that.
Yes, I did.
How excited are you now going to the trials? I mean, you've had some great success on the NCAA level, a gold medal winner. You know what big competition is all about. Mm-hmm. You're heading to it right now in Omaha.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I've been to the past two trials, but since I made the decision to move out here with the Nadadores, this is the first time I've had this real distance-oriented training, and I'm really excited to hopefully see it pay off at the Olympic trials. So
Coach was telling me around the 25-year-old mark is the prime time for women, female athletes in swimming. Obviously, she's 23. Now's the time, right?
Well, actually, again, yes, she's had some great, great experiences through college and now out of college. But I think it was in 2012 she won the NCAA championship and broke Janet Evans' record.
Who's that?
Great swimmer at the time.
She's never been on this pool deck before. Yeah.
And so she has been around and done very great things, but she's also made a terrific comeback in the fact that she got actually injured and ill for over a year and was bedridden for much of that time, and so really had to take off about 16, 18 months completely out of the water, and only in the last 18 months or so has she been back, and she has done fantastic over that period of time.
I know we don't have time to go into all that. Welcome back.
Thank you.
That signifies you as an outstanding athlete, not only physically, but mentally. Do you feel like you have the advantage going into this mentally? Because you've been to the trials. You know what to expect.
Yeah, I feel that I've competed and gotten enough experience at international meets and at the NCAA level and then at Olympic trials. So I feel mentally prepared for this meet.
What do you like most about swimming? Because obviously swimmers are great athletes to begin with. You could have probably played several different sports. Why swimming?
Swimming's the one that stuck with me the most. Growing up in Florida, the summers get extremely hot, so I would always be at the pool. And my mom was like, how about you try out swimming competitively? And it just stuck with me. I loved it. So
you're competing, Stephanie, in the 400 free, the 200 free, and the 800 free.
Yeah.
Pretty long distance races.
Mm-hmm.
The endurance of all of them, does it matter to you when those events fall into place? Like, Does it matter if the 800's before the 4 or the 2? I'm not really sure how that breaks down, mm-hmm. but can you explain that to us?
It doesn't matter to me. The 800 is going to end up being my last event, which I think I'm actually pretty thankful for, though, because I'll get to get some of the pre-race nerves out for like the 200 and then the 400. Sure. So kind of get a feel for the water.
Coach, yeah. Who will be her biggest competition this year?
Well, the very biggest competition, again, is Katie Ledecky. She's the world record holder and far and away the leading candidate, if you will. However, they do take two people to for each particular distance in each particular race. And so Katie will be very, very big, and there are another about four or five ladies that are very, very close. She this year actually has done actually the best of all of those, and we're really, really looking forward to that particular competition because her chances of making the Olympic team are as good as anyone out there.
That's fair. Coming from him, that's great. We wish you the best of luck.
And
I know with that beautiful smile, you've got a great future ahead of you,
Thank you.
Bill Rose only brings the best right here, right, Bill?
You betcha.
We'll be back with more of Coach's Corner. By the way, we mentioned Janet Evans. Janet Evans is the one who passed the torch to Muhammad Ali during the last Olympic Games when they were in Los Angeles. Swimmers do have big profiles. We congratulate Janet on that and all the excitement that she brought to the pool deck here. More than that, Adores, right after this.
Why go anywhere else for your remodel project when you can find everything here at Decor and Tile? Our expert staff has years of experience, which is passed on to you whether you are a homeowner, contractor, or designer. At Decor and Tile, we make your project easy with our beautiful and unique showroom filled with tile, stone, decorative glass, wood tile, granite, and quartz like Pentel, Caesarstone, and USA Cambria. Find out why Decor and Tile is the most referred showroom in South Orange County. Come in, call, or visit us on the web today.
Do you remember where you were on June 20th of 2016? Well, that's the day we taped the show, and that's the day it was about 106 in Mission Viejo, but it's cooled down rather nicely here on the pool deck as we talk with the Nadadores. Again, Bill Rose joining me. Now, another fine athlete, only 16 years old out of Santa Margarita Catholic High School. She'll be a junior with the Eagles next year. And this is Samantha Shelton. And she went and represented the United States of America in Singapore at the World Junior Championships as a 15-year-old. So you are off to a flying start already. Slow down, girl. Enjoy life a little.
Thank you.
So, Coach, this is an exceptional young athlete.
Yeah, she has been ever since I've known her, and I've known her since she was 8 years old when she started. And she started with my wife, who was her coach the very first year she was here. And so I was able to, through my wife, get to know her as well. And she's just made great strides right along the way. And the future is really in front of her.
Yeah. And what I noticed first, you're a tall girl. How tall are you?
I'm 5'11".
Are you still growing?
Yeah, I think I'm still growing.
So how is that affecting your swimming? Because did you grow in leaps and bounds, or is it just a little along the way?
I've always been tall for my age, so it hasn't really affected me much. I use my length as an advantage in the water.
Tell me about the edge that you think you have when you look on the blocks and you see maybe a girl that's, you know, 4 or 5 inches smaller than you.
Well, it definitely gives me confidence knowing that I'm like taller and I have an advantage, but that's not all. I think my hard work is why I'm fast, and it pays off.
And not only are you a gifted physical athlete, but Coach, she has to be mentally strong at such a young age. Can you tell me about that?
Well, indeed, yes, because she's, as I say, been in the sport, been a high-level age group swimmer the whole time, and indeed, she's had to carry herself at a high level along the way.
Yeah, and Samantha, when you're walking around the campus at Santa Margarita, does the volleyball coach come up to you? Does the basketball coach come up to you? If they don't know who you are already, do they say, hey, come play some ball with us?
Yeah, I've definitely gotten, like, people coming up to me saying you should be a volleyball player, basketball, because of my height.
Yeah.
But I love swimming. I truly think that I have the most passion for swimming, and it just gives me freedom when I dive in. So
where does that passion come from? Because this is not a sport where you just practice a little. It's a sport that you have to wake up very early in the morning, no matter what the weather is, mm-hmm. get in the pool, and no matter how you're feeling, swim. Mm-hmm. Where does that passion and that drive come from?
Well, every time I wake up before morning practice, I always remind myself of my goals and going to the Olympics. So my goals push me to go to morning practice and do the work.
Knowing that you're so young, and that's an advantage, believe me, at 16, going to the Olympic trials, what is your objective? Obviously to get there, but you can't be terribly disappointed that if you don't make it, because you'll have that bank of experience. Mm-hmm. You've already competed on a world level in Singapore and probably other competitions. So tell me about the excitement and what's your objective once you get there?
Well, I just want to have a fun meet and learn a lot from the swimmers and the Olympians who will be competing there and go best times.
Yeah, Coach, realistically, her chances are pretty good, right?
Actually, you never know. I've seen it happen before, and it's just a dream that everybody has, and sometimes the dream comes true. And also, they are picking what they call the Junior Pan Pack team off of the trials as well. So even if she doesn't make the Olympic team, she may very well be picked to this other international team, etc.
Before we let her go, give me some of the accolades, because again, she's got a lot recently that she's achieved.
Well, again, we're very proud of her and other Nadadores as well, but she did so very well at the high school level this year. She won CIF in both the 100 and the 200 and was named the Register Athlete of the Year and Orange County Swimmer of the Year and for women and as a sophomore in high school. So indeed, you can't get much better than that.
Yeah, well, you have a long and outstanding career ahead of you. Congratulations on all the success you've already had. Only 16 years old. Enjoy some of that summer too, all right?
Thank you.
All right, good luck at Omaha. She's on her way to Omaha. When we come back, we'll have yet another fantastic swimmer. I don't know how we can get any better, but we will on the men's side. More with the Nadadores after this.
Mission Basilica School is a Catholic parochial school with single grade classrooms from pre-kindergarten through eighth grade.
We have absolutely the best to offer in education. We don't just educate the child academically. They are nurtured spiritually. They are guided through their spiritual journey. They are loved, every being of them.
A blue ribbon school for academic excellence, located on the beautiful grounds of Mission San Juan Capistrano, Mission Basilica School.
This is one particular show that I wish it was an hour long, because we have such great athletes. Joining us now is Grant Shoults, recently named the Orange County Register Athlete of the Year. We'll say in all divisions, because whatever we say on this show is true, but deservingly so. Grant is an awesome competitor, recently graduated also from Santa Margarita Catholic High School, on his way to Stanford, competing right now, as it looks like, at least five events. They might change that as they get to Omaha. But first of all, congratulations on all your awesome success.
Thank you very much. Thank you for the generous introduction, too.
Oh, it's easy, man. Right, Coach? It's easy. How long have you had Grant on the team?
Actually, he's been here 7 or 8 years. And I first noticed Grant, interestingly enough, at a open water race in San Francisco. He just turned 14, and he just showed up or went to the race. And I remember he and I had lunch, and I said, "Why, have you ever done this before?" "No." I said, "Well, why are you doing this?" "I don't know. I just thought it'd be fun to go to San Francisco."
Did that change your direction that particular day with swimming?
I mean, to have Coach Rose say some kind words about you, is definitely a pretty cool experience. I was a 14-year-old. I was still doing multiple sports at the time, and so to have a figurehead for USA Swimming compliment you, it's pretty cool.
Honest with me when I ask you this question, why are you so good?
I owe a lot to Coach Rose, a lot to this program, a lot to the Nadadores, a lot to the city also. I wouldn't be sitting here today if I wasn't for this program. I came from another club, and it was an awesome club, but kind of disbanded, and I came here. And now it's my new home. I learned so much from Coach Rose, also from the other coaches too, Coach Bill Voigt. You know, they really shape me into the swimmer I am.
Right.
The way I compete is an exact mirror of how they coach. You know, back half swimming is the way to go.
And you're competing in quite a few athletes. The 400, no, I'm sorry, let's go, yeah, the 400, the 200, 400 free, the 200 free, the 200 fly, the 200 IM, and also the 1500. And it was interesting because during the event tonight, they had Brian Goodell's video of when he won the Olympic gold medal in Montreal. And he came from behind. That gave me the chills watching that. Did that inspire you a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I've actually seen that video a couple times. You know, that's just Mission Viejo. That's the way we do it here.
Coach, your thoughts. His future in the next couple of weeks is going to be real busy.
Those are nice words that he said about me. But I will tell you this, and I've told other coaches this, that effectively he could have made it in any sport he chose.
Right.
He's probably, from an athlete point of view, the greatest athlete I've ever coached, and I've coached a few years.
That's saying something, my friend.
And with that in mind, once he really understands how good he really is and putting the work plus the ability together, there's nothing to stop him.
I had this young kid on by the name of Tiger Woods as an 18-year-old, and his high school coach was sitting here, basically said the same thing, and he went on to achieve great things. At that time, Tiger knew that he was going to go on to do great things. Do you envision yourself as going on to do great things? I think you do, because otherwise you wouldn't be sitting here.
I mean, I believe what Coach Rose says. You know, I remember going to Singapore, and he told me, like, you deserve to be here. You know, you've put in the work to get everything done and, you know, to get on that podium, take everything in, and, you know, great things will happen. And, you know, I've been listening to Coach Rose for a long time now, and, you know, I do believe what he says.
Well, you're on your way to Omaha. Maybe right after that, you'll be getting ready to go to Brazil. If so, good luck to you. Either way, a phenomenal athlete. Congratulations on also going to Stanford University. That's not too bad either.
Thank you very much.
All right, Bill, you brought another good one. When we come back, we'll have yet another cool story with the Nadadores, an established athlete with another country that's going to go compete for his country but swim in the heart of a Nadador. We'll be back with more after this.
Why go anywhere else for your remodel project when you can find everything here at Decor and Tile? Our expert staff has years of experience, which is passed on to you whether you are a homeowner, contractor, or designer. At Decor and Tile, we make your project easy with our beautiful and unique showroom filled with tile, stone, decorative glass, wood tile, granite, and quartz like Pentel, Caesarstone, and USA Cambria. Find out why Decor and Tile is the most referred showroom in South Orange County. Come in, call, or visit us on the web today.
The fantastic thing about the Mission Viejo Nadadores is they recruit athletes and attract athletes from all over the world. Os Mellouli is one of those athletes from Tunisia, a four-time Olympian, soon to be a fifth-time Olympian. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And you were just saying that you didn't really know what time it was because you just got back. Where were you at?
Yeah, me and Coach Rose were at the 10K Olympic qualifier in Portugal in the beautiful Setúbal, and we clutched the spot for the 10K Olympic race. We're all set to go to Rio this summer.
It's amazing. So I know that he's not going to go represent in USA because he's going to represent his own country, but he is a Nadador, so he's got the Nadador in the heart, right?
Right, and I also want to make sure that give him kudos to the fact that he is now a USA citizen.
Yes.
And so that's something that I know he's quite proud of, et cetera. And after spending many years here at 32, he's been in the U.S. for many years. And I went to USC and indeed will continue his education as well after this.
That's fantastic. So I could ask you question after question, but it's got to be still exciting to know that you're going to yet another Olympic Games. Tell us about that, because you've won two gold medals already.
Yeah, it's very exciting to go to Rio. I'm looking forward to racing Copacabana, which is one of the most famous beaches in the world, and hopefully end my career on a high note. I've been blessed to have such a successful ride in my swimming career. I traveled the world. I competed, swam at USC, and now finishing off my career with the Nadadores has been quite the story for me, and very fortunate to have lived it. But going to a fifth Olympic Games is something very special and very proud of. And it's been a lot of work and a lot of hard work. And we're just very happy that we qualified this past week. And we're still, I'm still digesting it, really. Oh, yeah. So,
Coach, is that uncommon that an athlete will go five times to the Olympics?
No, especially in the events that he's competed in, because distance swimming is something that literally over the years, putting 4 or 6 hours a day back and forth, you know, 10 miles a day, yeah, for years, just keep counting it. I mean, it takes its toll. And so to have someone last as long as he has in the events that he has is almost unheard of.
With that said, how do you keep your focus in the pool, being in the water that long? You must have that yoga mentality to be in the water in your own zone. Tell us about that.
Personally, I tend to be working a lot on my technique. I'm very focused the whole time just to fine-tune my technique and be as efficient as possible while I'm in the water. So that does keep me busy, and obviously Coach Rose here will definitely keep us focused, throwing different things at us and keeping us challenged. So it's I find it hard to drift in your thoughts when you're in the pool. I'm always trying to fine-tune my stroke and trying to lengthen it a little bit, trying to focus on little things. And I think it's very important to stay focused.
Coach, what do you tell an athlete of this caliber? I mean, he's been there now four times, getting ready to go to his fifth time. What do you tell somebody like this?
You know, once he's been there, done that, et cetera, I think we work together more than I coach him. We're trying to find the best way for him to be the best he can be now and even get better. And that's really, really a team effect at this particular point. Yeah. So, but at the same time, he's one that says, I don't want to do it myself. I want you to tell me what to do, and I want you to guide me. He's happy with that, and so that's important.
Will you coach? What will you do when swimming, you hang up swimming? You're going to school. I think Coach said still you're going to get your degree. You probably already have it or whatever, but you're on your way.
Yeah.
Will you teach or coach? Or tell me about that aspect, post-swimming.
Coaching is very tough. It's a lot of patience, and it doesn't mean...
Wait a minute, being in the water 10 miles a day, you don't have patience?
It's a different patience. I see all my coaches, and I have a lot of respect for them because they leave such an impact on everybody that comes across them and that works with them, and it's a tough job. It really is a tough job, and it takes a lot of patience and a lot of, I don't know, they pour their heart and soul in their craft, and it's a long time to see a swimmer develop, and it doesn't, you're not guaranteed the result, and that's the toughest part too. So, I don't know, I would love to stay involved in the sport somehow, whether it's in the Olympic Committee of my home country or whether it's in the International Olympic Committee or the governing body of the Swimming International Federation. But I'm not sure, I'm just really enjoying the ride right now and staying focused on what I have to do in the next 6 to 8 weeks. And hopefully bring home to the Nadadores another Olympic medal. That would be amazing.
Well, it's such an honor to have you on the set of our show.
Thank you for
having me. Participating as a Nadador. The reason, as he has said, and all the other athletes that we've had on the show today, the reason why the Nadadores are so good and so well respected, and I know you agree on this, is because of this man right here, Bill Rose.
Thank you. That's
great guy. Great guy. And what a great job. Congratulations on all the stuff that you, all the things that you've done here with the Nadadores. For all of our Nadadores that were on the show, we had so many great ones. We're going to leave the show now with a look at all the athletes from the Nadadores that are going to the trials. For all of them, good luck. Thank you for watching. I'm Paul Higgins. This has been Coach's Corner.
We are the Nadadores, and we're going to Olympic trials.